Christmas Day, the rebels from LRA, Lord Resistance Army, attack two villages, Farage and Doroma, in northern Congo. The LRA has been attacking civilian population in this region for 7 months. MSF has been present in the Owele region since October, assisting population affected by violence and displacement. When the LRA eat villages, they rape, loot, kill people.
Et les fillettes, ils couchent avec
eux.
Ils brûlent les maisons. À Kilwa, ils ont tout brûlé le village. Ils ont tué vraiment la majorité. Ils ont arrêté même les écoliers. Ah, vraiment, ils sont tellement tristes.
One of the characteristics of the LRA is that they adopt children first to help them to bring all the looting, but also to try to make them child soldiers. In the different villages where we have been able to go just after the attack, most of the time we can see adults coming back alone, keeping their children hidden in the forest just to avoid them to be kidnapped by the LRA. Following the Christmas attack, we have been deployed MSF team in the two locations affected by the violence, Farage and Doroma, to rescue wounded people and refer them back to Dungu Hospital for surgical care. One of our staff, Dr. Mathieu, who could go in Farage and Doroma just after the attack, explained the situation of the population there.
A few days after the attack of Farage, who killed, I mean, the LRL killed about 75 people. And so we went there and we visited the hospital, and the hospital has been looted by the LRA. And so this, there were no nurse, no doctors, and we saw some wounded people, and we evacuated the most serious. We evacuated to the Dungu Hospital by plane.
It seems that there are not a lot of injured people. I mean, comparing with the number of deaths, could you explain that?
Yeah, that's right. This was especially the case in another village called Doroma, which is in the northwest. And I mean, it can be pregnant women, children. Everybody was killed. And the fact is that there's not many injuries, because I think LRA now wants really to kill people, and there is still kidnapping. I mean, this is still going on, but. It seems that now it's more killing than kidnapping, probably. There is a lot of displaced people because they are afraid of attack, or because there has been an attack on their village. So they just hide in the bush most of the time. We try the maximum to assist the people without taking so much risk, especially on the north area. We are trying to support some dysentery or some hospitals. In the south, we do some clinic mobile with a car. We just move around and we stop in some place, and then we do some consultation there. It's a very complicated situation for an intervention, that's sure.